Jason. I have some more books to show with you today, and I got my first textbooks. Woo! But first, we'll share what I got in the mail. I got Infinity Ring by James Dashner. It's Scholastic sent it to me because I marked them off when I was at their party. It is History is Broken. When best friends Jack Smith and Sarah Frosty stumble upon the key to time travel, a handheld device known as the Infinity Ring, they're swept up in centuries-long secret war for the fate of mankind. Recruited by the historians, a secret society founded long ago by Aristotle, the kids learn that history has gone disastrously off course. Now it's up to Jack, Sarah, and young historian Rick to travel back in time to fix the great breaks and to save Jack's missing parents while they're at it. So that one looks cool, and this one has like a little virtual game you can play on it too that James Nashner showed us. So, and from Harlequin Teen Panel, I got a copy of Saving June by Hannah Harrington. It says, "Everyone's sorry, but no one can explain why." And this one's been out for a while, I think. I believe it has. I've seen lots of reviews, but I personally haven't read it, so I'm excited that I got a finished copy from them. I got this little sweet package here. Isn't this the cutest package ever? From Macmillan. And they wanted to thank me for being a part of their blog tours. So they sent me Fierce Reads tattoos. I got a Struck tattoo, maybe. I think it goes like that. It's those Lindbergh or whatever marks. And then I got some more bookmarks I'll be giving away. One of each of the books in the Fierce Reads tour this past time around. Chris Bolton, for her new series, the Witch Avenue series, she sent me soaps. I think maybe she handmade them herself. I wouldn't be surprised because they're so cute. And they're different, like, the smells are all from the book. And it says, this one says it's from Logan because it's lemon. And that's the one that, he wore. And, like, Triss said it smelled good. Lavender, my absolute favorite, is what Triss would wear. And then the fig one from Logan. And these are the most adorable things ever, I think. And then lots of stuff on my bed, lots of stuff. I started these, but Friday I had orientation at Ferris, and then Tirza was working at Great Lakes Books and Supply. I think that's what it's called. I have the bag somewhere. Oh, it's bad that I can't remember. So I went and saw her and bought my textbooks. But that same day, I went to DJ at DJ's Life and Fiction, and he wrote Hunted. He's a friend of mine, so I went to his benefit concert, and since it was at Schuler's, I had to get Tiger's Curse by Colleen Huck, because I was going to buy an ebook because I'm getting pretty full in books in my room, and I don't really have a lot of room for them much anymore. So I was going to get an ebook, but there is no Kindle ebook of it, and I was kind of outraged at the time because, I mean, it's a bestseller, and it has had a lot of success, and I just don't understand. But this one, the little blurb on the back says, "I was dying. I knew it. At least the pain is gone. I wanted to tell him that I loved him. Then darkness overtook me." Bam! Let's see how far am I in this. I am, and this is the paperback one because I couldn't bring myself to buy the hardcover. Page 54, and plug your ears quick. I'll make a sign, like, this means I'm saying, this means we're good. After I'll get your attention, watch, but maybe plug your ears. I really hope the tiger in this book that she is talking to is, like, a really hot guy who's going to change into it. Because that would make my day, woo! Anyways, it has a cool thing. It's pretty. But then, also there, I picked up, I was so stupid when I picked this one up. Like, I knew it wasn't, I knew, like, I needed them because I have one bookstore, well, I have two bookstores by me, but one's a small indie, and it only carries, like, adult books, but that's alright, but since we're a very conservative community, there isn't very many paranormal books like this, or fantasy books in the store. Not that there's nothing wrong with that, I just wish they had more of a selection and all. But, and then we have a really tiny Barnes & Noble, a really tiny one, and I, like, hate Barnes & Noble, the way they organize books. They get me so frustrated. So I bought this one, and at the time, I bought this one, and I didn't know what it was. So I was, like, looking at the back of a book and, like, the front cover, because, you know, there's usually a series in it. And stupid me didn't look at this little spine, number 3. But I wanted it anyways, because I know. Anyways. So I'm excited because I have the third one. But then I was like, oh, cool, we're in Grand Rapids, because we're never really in Grand Rapids for the Schuler's thing at DJ's afterwards. I was like, there's an Apple store here. I should go. Because I need like this pink skin shell thingy for my new MacBook Pro. And so I was going to get one. I got them. I'm only freaking 13 inches. So this hot guy, Mac guy talked to me. They're all pretty cute in there except for a couple of them. And he's like, you can... order that online, you know. I'm like, yeah, of course. I gave him, like, stupid, dumb guy. Like, I was just at the, I know what I want because I was at the Apple store, but I didn't want to pay shipping or anything, so I wanted to get it here, and I was like, ugh. And then I went to Fossilizer because, like, I couldn't figure out my watch. I was having a tough day. And I was running on, like, a half hour sleep that day, so that is a whole nother story. But then, once I was at the mall, and there's a Barnes & Noble, and I don't like Barnes & Noble, since, you know, I'd rather buy them from Indies. But I knew I had to get it, because there's no stores around me, and I was in Grand Rapids, and that doesn't normally happen. And so I bought the second one. And then I took pictures in each of the bookstores that I bought these in for her, Colleen. And I sent them to him, so I think she probably thinks I'm like a crazy stalker, but I really needed these books, like, really badly. But, like, I shouldn't have, because it's textbook time. Big Rapids, where Ferris State University is that I'm going to, is about an hour and 36 minutes from my house. Yeah, I know. I got to schedule classes. Woo! These are all the pre-nursing, because then, like, you have to cover all your requirements, and then you get into nursing program, and the nursing program is year-round, so even in the summertime, for 2 years straight, but it's a 4-year bachelor's program, but there's certain things you have to require, but I got to skip, like, all of these, but one, and a couple other of them, because I already, like, filled out the requirements already. Anyways, let's look at Erica's thing. She has math 4 freaking days a week, and then I have chemistry 4 days, and twice on one day, and I have sociology 3 days, communications 1 day, and Ferris State University seminar 1 day. So, I got all my books but my sociology book, so let's start with the boring ones first. I have another class 2 in Sign Language. This is Medical Terminology Express. Looks pretty easy. It's an online course. It's like terms that I did in high school when I was in human anatomy and stuff. That'd be hard. Did I just rip a page? Nope. But this is mine. Woo! And it's used. Which is good, because I got an Interplay, the Process of Interpersonal Communication, which promises to be boring. But actually, this, I just, on the back it says gaydar. Maybe it will teach me to have a better gaydar. And then I have my chemistry book. Ooh, chemistry! Which I've suppressed all knowledge from junior year. And then this is my favorite book ever, even though I do not want to take this mathematics class. Well, it just called it Math 117. It's one of the harder ones. It was the hardest one they offered because all the other easier ones were taken, so they're all closed because they're full. But I went to pick up this book, and look it, there is a cow on it. A freaking cow, guys. Let's not think about how it says thinking mathematically and how my brain doesn't think mathematically. Just look at the cow. It makes the class so much better. Like, I don't really have a thing for cows, but oh my god, there's a face on this back. Like, look it. Look it. I'm so excited. So, I move in August 24th, and then it's going to be me, Tirza, and we are going to have a big party, I think. Well, I don't know what party, but maybe Tirza's friend Tabitha will hang out with us too, and we can talk about books and have fun. And I haven't met my roommate yet, but that will be good too. And I'll be doing more of these vlogs because I have that new iMovie thing. It's going to be fun. Can I say fun again? Fun! So I will talk to you guys later.
The stars creak, I should sleep, it's keeping me awake.
It's the house telling you to close your eyes.
And something.